You have improved.
Learn from the best.
Even the best get to point where it's time to slow down.
Maybe you should take a trip. Get out of your mundane routine.
Actually, I've always wanted to go to South Africa.
Well, that's a great place. I've actually thought of going again.
Again?
Maybe you and I can go together.
I didn't know you were doing that well.
Well, it's all about what you do with what you have, right? As soon as I had enough savings, I started investing in mutual funds. You know what they say. Every drop counts. I kept investing every month. My investments grew. And so did my income. It was actually easy to build it up from there. All I needed was time.
What about the volatility of the share prices? I mean, they seem to keep going up and down without any rhyme and reason.
But those are just short-term price movements. That has nothing to do with the business of the company. It's the long-term price movements that reflect and, you know, judge the company's performance.
If that is the case, why not just buy shares directly? Why mutual funds?
Well, investing directly is tedious. You know, you need both the time and the skill for it. Mind you, both, not just one or the other. You also need to have the interest for it. You know, for the numbers and the process. Otherwise, you're just better off hiring an expert. Or rather, mutual funds in this case.
They must be charging a bomb though. Also, how do I trust that the mutual fund would not run away with my money?
Well, they cannot do that. And you know, mutual funds have a very highly regulated structure, which ensures that they cannot run away with the investor's money. And also, there'll be an asset management company that manages the fund, which is owned by the investors. So basically, people like you and me.
But who holds the investments?
They're held with a third party, which would be registered with SEBI. And the actual money would be in a bank account or invested in the name of the fund.
So what's the point of the asset management company then?
They're just there to manage the assets, not to own them. The ownership is completely with us. The managers can only charge whatever amounts to their fees. And SEBI has imposed limits on the maximum expenses that can be charged by the mutual fund managers. The AMC cannot charge beyond these SEBI-specified limits. And the risk of losing money is only limited to the change in market price.
That's quite a smart plan. Seems like I can learn a thing or two from you as well. Checkmate.